Well, I finally adjusted my throttle or my air fuel mixture screw last night. And I was just going to show you how I did it.
So hopefully this lighting's good enough to show you what I did here. There's probably a lot of ways to do this. What I did was first I took off the seat. See, everybody knows how to do that. There's a couple bolts. One's right there. One's on the other side, right about here. Took off this panel. I don't even know if you have to do that, but that's what I did. And you got to twist this carburetor to get down under here. Unless you got some special little tool to get under there, but I didn't. So first you turn the fuel off. Turn it to that position right there. Put a vice grip right here on the fuel line. And I'll show you a picture here. I took some pics while I was doing it. And I just strapped a bungee cord on it and around. And then you pinch these right here with some needle nose, pull them up right under the vice grips, pop this up, and then you can twist the carburetor. So it's that screw right there and that screw right there. And those are the clamps that hold the carburetor on. And you loosen them up and then you can twist this whole thing. I twisted it towards so I could get at it on the right side of the bike. Apparently some people can just unhook these throttle cables real easily. I couldn't because I have bar risers on and they're tight. And if you don't have bar risers, maybe you can do that easily. I don't know. I was gonna mess with all that if I didn't have to. So you just twist it this way so you can get to the bottom here. It's right here is this, well, I don't know if you can see that or not, but it's the one right next to this one. It's over here. And there's a little plug in there. And what I did, there's some direct sunlight coming in, but I took this wood screw. So it's a self-tapping screw. So you can see the little self-tapping drill bit part of it at the end. And I just stuck it up in there like that. Held some pressure on it with my finger and turned it with a wrench, or turned it with some pliers, you know, and that took, you know, 20 minutes, something like that, until it went up in there tight enough to pry this little plug out. And that's what that looks like. It's still attached to that thing. I just left it there. It looks just to make this video, actually. And, you know, this thing will be angled out a little bit this way so you can get to it better. It's kind of straight up and down right now. I got some good pictures of that, what that looks like before and after. And you can see there's a little screw in there, a little flathead screw, little gold screw. You can see this little mark I put right there. Right there. Maybe I can zoom in on that after I make this video. There's a little mark I left there, and that's where, you know, the screwdriver was like this, and I counted how many turns it took to screw it in all the way. And it took a little more than one half turn, like maybe just a little bit more, not three quarters. It wasn't three quarters, it was just a little bit more than a half. And it was all the way in. And what you do is, a lot of people go 2 1/4 turns out. I did two turns out. And the bike was cold and I started it right up without the choke for the first time ever. And it wasn't really cold, you know. Well, I mean, it wasn't freezing cold. It was like, you know, 75 degrees last night when I did it. So it wasn't like, you know, in the middle of winter or something, but it was cold. I hadn't ridden it in a couple days. And it started right up and it wasn't cold-blooded at all. Now, some people report some surging. I haven't test ridden this yet, but some people report like a surging. And I think I noticed that even in first and second gear in my driveway last night, just on a test ride to warm it up and check it out, there was a little bit of a surging. And I'm not sure if that's such a big deal, or that's why I didn't go 2 1/4 turns, because I wanted to like test it out. But see, now that I took that plug out, I used this little bit right here. See, I got a little mark on there that lines up with a mark on the where that screw is. So it's a little bit of a pain, you know, It's hard to do with one hand, obviously, with holding the camera. But I think now I can mess with it without messing with the carburetor at all. And I can go, you know, 1.5, 1 turnout, 2.25, you know, just test out different things. I'm going to take it for a test drive in a minute here. And I haven't started it since last night. I'll do a cold start and see what it does today. But I just want to make a quick video. That's how you do it. And then you button everything up. It's real easy. I should have done it a long time ago. It's kind of a pain to get that little plug out of there. That's a good look right there. Maybe you can zoom in it. That's the screw right there.
Here, I'm on the side of the bike.
And that's it. And then you got a richer air-fuel mixture, and that allows it to start easier and not be so cold-blooded. And it might even have more power. I don't know. Maybe a little bit. This bike doesn't have much power anyway. But.
So I don't think I missed anything. I just want to make a quick video. Show you how I did it. It's real easy. It's no problem. I recommend doing it, especially if your bike's cold-blooded or needs a lot of choke to start and needs a lot of time to warm up. And they're all a little bit different from the factory. People report, you know, quarter turnout, half turnout, 1 turnout, 1.25 turnout from being bottomed out. So who knows why that is, but it's good to be able to adjust that anyways. All right, later.